Hi. One of the biggest things that we see B2B SaaS marketers struggling with is how they expand their paid search activities. Normally, this is the case because paid search is the highest converting, highest ROI channel. And usually the answer comes down to keyword expansion. But oftentimes the marketer will say, well, we've just really saturated the keywords that we can find. We've saturated the intent. Well, I want to present here a framework for keyword expansion for SaaS marketers that goes beyond simply intent. In fact, it presents different layers of intent. So first we have brand. Now this would be your direct brand or maybe your competitor's brand. And here, these keywords are going to see the highest conversion rate. Let's say maybe this is a 15% conversion rate. I'll use green for conversion rate here. But these terms are very limited in terms of their volume. So then you move out to the next layer of this onion or this dartboard to your category keywords. And your category keywords are going to give you more volume, but at a slightly lower conversion rate. So let's say these category conversion rate is like 8%. So you're sacrificing here about half. And then if you saturate the category keywords, that's usually where most marketers stop. Then you have to look to the adjacent categories, especially if you're one of these so-called SaaS trailblazers. Not many people know about your category, and you have to look for adjacent categories. And you have to get people to think about your category in a different way so that they can move from where they are looking for that category to your adjacent category. But you will sacrifice conversion rate. So let's say here your conversion rate drops maybe to 3%. And if you've gone this far and you're still looking for ways to expand your keywords and keep spending more and getting that sweet ROI from paid search, the last layer of this onion are keywords that indicate that you have your ideal customer persona performing the search. They might not have anything to do with your brand, your category, or even adjacent categories. But due to the nature of the terms, you can reasonably expect that people that are searching for those terms fit your ideal customer profile. Now here, you're going to sacrifice again with a lower conversion rate. So I'm going to put maybe 1% conversion rate here. Now the key when you model this out is that you have to test the conversion rate decay every time you move one level out to a different ring on this dartboard. Brand keywords, high conversion rate, they'll get saturated quickly. Category keywords, you sacrifice conversion rate. Adjacent keywords and ICP keywords keep moving out. But what you can do is you can measure the cost per click. And what you need to have here is you need the cost per click to be on average reducing to the same degree that you have the reduction in your conversion rate, because then you could expect to see roughly the same ROI. This is not always possible, but you have to test it in order to find out if the sacrifice you're paying on a conversion rate still can be profitable, given hopefully a lower cost per click. If the cost per click is getting more expensive as you move out from here, then it's probably not going to work. So this is a pretty good framework. Think about using this when you think about a campaign and an account structure in your paid search that can accommodate keyword expansion. Thanks.